Now let us look at the following examples. Here in these examples we are going to design DFAs, and let us see the example number 1. It says if we have the language for A and B over A comma B, then the language is AB raised to power N should be accepted and N is greater than or equal to 0. Okay, so what are the strings which are present in this particular language? We can have epsilon, we can have AB, we can have AB, AB, we can have AB, 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 and so on. Right, but in this language, what are the strings which are present? These are AB, 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 and so on. The only difference between these two languages is the above language accepts epsilon, that means string of length 0, but this language does not accept as epsilon. Right, only these two languages are over A comma B. Okay, so let us design the first language where we accept epsilon. In the first language, this is the initial state, which is A, and we have to make the initial state as final state because epsilon is accepted. If epsilon is accepted, then we have to make initial state as final state in case of DFA. Therefore, this is a final state. Okay, now we have to accept the string after every AB, AB. So if we get a, if we get a, then we'll go to the state B. If we get again B, then we can again go to the state A. And here, if I get any other combination, then AB, AB, for example, after this A, we get one more A, then it should not be accepted. We'll go to the state C, and its state C is a trap state. But initially, if we got B, right, then we go to state C again, or you can say state D. Better is if you want to minimize it, then make it to go to state C. Okay, now you can check. If you give any combination of AB, AB, for example, we have AB, AB, A, B, A, B, right? Even if you are going to give this string AB, 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 A, B, A, B, A, B. So whenever you are going to get a combination which is AB, AB, then that combination will be accepted. But if you get a combination which is not containing AB, AB, that means a combination like A, A, B, B. Now, or you can say combination like A, A, B, or you get a combination like A, B, B. Now, these combinations should not be accepted. For example, in this first combination, A and A, that means we'll go to the trap state, so this will not be accepted. In this combination also, it will go to the trap state, so it will not be accepted. In the third combination, first A will take us from A to B, the second B will take us from B to A, and the third B will take us from A to C. Therefore, this will not also not be accepted. Okay, so this is the DFA which is representing the first language. Now in the second language, the length of the string is greater than or equal to 1. That means we will not be having epsilon. Now if we don't have epsilon, then initial state will not be the final state. So for the second case, for this case, how we are going to draw a DFA, this is the initial state A, and will not make the initial state as final state because epsilon is not accepted. Now as soon as we get 1A, then we'll go to the state B, and as soon as we get one more B, then we'll go to the state C, and it should be accepted. Now if you get any combination, again repeated combinations, for example AB, AB, right, so again we'll go to the state C. Now initially we can have a B also. If we get a B here, then we'll get to go to the trap state, which is assume D, and we'll always be stuck here. But after getting this A, if we get one more A, then again we'll be at the trap state because those strings should not be accepted. And here in this C, if you get one more B, that means we are getting something which is out of the combination, that means we'll go to the trap state. Okay, what do I mean to say? If, for example, if you get a string which is A, A, B, A, B. Now in this string, the first combination is not at all accepting, is not at all in the string. Therefore, this combination should not be accepted. If you check first double A, this is string is not accepted because of these two A's. So if you give first A, then you will go from A to B. For the second A, you go from B to D. Therefore, it is not accepted. Now, if you get a combination like B, A, B, A, B. Now, this combination should not be accepted because initially we are getting a B. So if initially we are getting a B, then we'll go to the state D, which is a trap state. Or if you get a combination like A, B, A, B, B. Now this combination should not be accepted because in the end we get a B. So initially from A to B, then after seeing this B, from we'll go from B to C. After seeing this A, we'll go from C to B. After seeing this B, we'll go from B to C. After seeing this B, we go from C to D. Therefore, this should not be accepted or we are going to the trap state. Now if you get a string like A, B, A, B, A, B. Now in this particular string, after seeing the first A, we are going from A to B. After seeing this B, we are going from B to C. After seeing this A, we are going to from C to B. After seeing this B, we are going from B to C. After seeing this A, we are going from C to B. After seeing this B, we are going from B to C. Therefore, this string is accepted and the string is in the format AB raised to power n such that n is greater than or equal to 1. Okay, therefore this kind of string is accepted. So this is the difference between these two kind of DFAs, where the main difference is n is greater than or equal to 0 and n is greater than or equal to 1. If you have n is greater than or equal to 0, that means epsilon state should be there. Therefore, the initial state will be final state. Right? If you get epsilon greater than or equal to 1, then initial state cannot be a final state because we don't want it to accept the epsilon. Okay, now check out the third question. Actually, the numbering should be 3, this one is 3, this is 4, 5, 6 and 7, but anyways, let us assume it as fourth question. So, it is saying design a DFA which checks whether a unary number is divisible by 3 or not. See, to know if a unary number is divisible by 3 or not, first of all, you should know what is a unary number, what is a binary number, ternary, quinary and so on. See, what happens is these kind of number system they are used to represent some kind of objects. For example, assume this is you, okay, and this is your barn or something, okay, and you have some sheeps here, okay. Now the problem with you is you don't know how to read and you don't know how to count. So what you do, your main aim is in morning you take all these sheeps out of the barn, you take them to have some grass or something, and then in evening you bring them back inside the barn. And number of sheeps which you have, it's large in number. You can have sheeps or goats or whatever you like, so that's very large in number. Now what is happening is there's someone here who is interested in stealing your sheeps, and you want to ensure that number of sheeps you took out in the morning, the same number of sheeps came back. Now in that case, if you don't know how to count, so it will be very difficult. So what you can do is you can take a bag like this. As soon as one sheep goes out, you can put a stone inside this bag. As soon as second sheep goes out, you can put a stone. As soon as third sheep goes out, you can put a stone. As soon as fourth sheep is going out, you can put a stone. So you can, after the end, you'll be having some collection of stones. And when you come back in evening, when these sheeps come back in evening, what you can do is, as soon as one sheep comes inside, you can take out one stone. As soon as second sheep comes out, you can take out second stone. As soon as third sheep comes in, then you can take out the third stone and so on. So if all the sheeps are inside the barn, and you still have some stones left, that means you can, you will be ensured that maybe some sheep are missing in this case. Now here these stones are acting as symbols to count. All these stones are of same type. All these stones are of same type. Therefore, these stones are giving a unary representation. Unary representation. Unary means you can only count one type of object, one single digit. Right? Because if you have 5 stones, that means you are counting 5. If you have 10 stones, that means you are counting 10. So in the same way, we can represent numbers by using different symbols. So we invented the number system. For example, if you have a unary number means that means you are having only one kind of combination or one single symbol to represent the numbers. That symbol can be 1 or that symbol can be 0. For example, assuming that symbol is 0, right? So if you want to count 3, then you will be writing 0, 0, 0. If you want to count 4, then you will be writing 0, 0, 0 and so on. Right? So you can write the symbols that many times that number according to the number which you want to count. Now the second number system which we given is called as binary number system, which is given denoted by base 2. Binary number system means we are going to have two combinations which are 0 and 1, or you can say two symbols. In case of ternary number systems, we'll be having three symbols which are 0, 1 and 2. In quaternary number system, we'll be having four symbols 0, 1, 2 and 3. In the same way, in octal number system, we'll be having 8 symbols 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and so on, till 7 only. When we discuss about decimal number system, that means we are having 10 symbols 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. In the same way, if we discuss about hexadecimal number system, that means we are having 16 symbols which are 0 to 9, and then we have capital A, B, C, D, E and F. E and F. Okay. Now why we are not using 10 here is because 10 itself is made up of the combination of 1 and 0, and we are already giving 1 and 0 here. We want every symbol to be different. These number systems are only representing a symbol. For example, when we talk about decimal number system, that means we are going to have 10 symbols. Thus, even you take any kind of, you know, language to represent these symbols. In Hindi, you represent these symbols. In English, you can represent these symbols. The basis of the number system, in everywhere, we are using decimal number system because the decimal number system is most easiest to remember. And you can, it is according to the human recognizable or human learning capability only. So every language, whether it is Hindi, whether it is Sanskrit, whether it is, you can take Yunani or any other language, always you will find that we are using decimal number system only. Any country, any language. Right. So this is decimal number system. That means we are going to have 10 combinations. And when we discuss about any of these number systems, we want to change this number system to decimal number system. Then what is the, you know, method? If you have some digits of that number system, for example, X, Y, Z are some digits, and you have the base P. P is, for example, it is a ternary number system. P is, for example, it is a quinary number system, or it is an octal number system. This is representing the base. We can have any base. Base 50, base 27, base 36, any whatever base. That means, base means these many unique symbols you have. Now, if you have, for example, X, Y, Z base P, then it can be represented by Z into P raised to power 0, plus y into p raised to power 1 plus x into p raised to power 2. And whatever number you are going to get, that number will be in decimal number system. That number will be in decimal number system. Now in this question we are saying, in these questions we are saying, design a DFA which checks whether a unary number is divisible by 3. Obviously, when I'm saying divisible by 3, that means we are discussing about the decimal values of those numbers. When we are saying design a DFA which checks whether a given string is a binary string, or you can say binary number is divisible by 3, that means we are taking the decimal value of those binary numbers. Here we are saying ternary numbers is divisible by 3, binary value of those ternary number, sorry, a decimal value of those ternary number, and I'm saying quinary number is divisible by 3, that means decimal value of those quinary numbers, and when I'm saying an octal number is divisible by 3, that means decimal value of those octal by 6, that means decimal values of those octal numbers. Okay, so we are going to use these different number systems to design the DFA. Okay. The question is, design a DFA which checks whether a given unary number is divisible by 3, and assume the only symbol we are going to use in that unary number is 0. Unary number means we are having only one kind of symbols. Binary number means we are having two kinds of symbols, ternary, three symbols, and so on. Okay, so for example, if you have a number which is 0, it is not divisible by 3. If you have 0, 0, it is not divisible by 3. If you have 0, 0, 0, it is divisible by 3. But better you see, to take human recognition, maybe in check, let us use 1 instead of 0. If you have 1, it is not divisible by 3. If you have 1, 1, it is not divisible by 3. If you have 1, 1, 1, it is divisible by 3. If you have 1, 1, 1, 1, not divisible by 3, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, not divisible by 3, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, it is divisible by 3. Right. So, this is unary number which is having only one symbol which is equal to 1. So, this is, I know, very simple because we just have to check what is the length of the string. If the length of the string is 3, 6, which is then all these lengths are divisible by 3, and I'm assuming that the length 0 is divisible by 3. Okay. So, what you can do is, this is the initial state. It is representing length 0, so it is a final state. Here, if you get 1, then we go to the state B. If you get 1 more 1, then we go to the state C. And if you get 1 more 1, then obviously it is divisible by 3. That means still accept all the strings of length which are multiple of 3. Now, here all the questions become quite interesting. The first one was, I know, because first one was very easy because we have already done those kinds of questions. But here these questions become quite, you know, interesting. Because when I am dividing numbers by 3 or 4 or 5 or 6 or 7 or 8, they become quite complicated. The best way is either you identify the pattern, that means what pattern is going on, and then you can make the DFA. Or I'll tell you a simple shortcut which you can use to solve these kinds of questions within seconds. It will take hardly 10 seconds to solve these kinds of questions. So first of all, in this question, let us try to identify if we can solve it using a pattern. Okay, so it is saying the DFA method checks a binary number is divisible by 3. See, if you have a binary number like 0, it is divisible by 3. If we have 0, 0, divisible by 3. If we have 0, 0, 0, divisible by 3. If you have only any number of zeros, then they are divisible by 3. If we have 0, 1, not divisible by 3. If you even have single 1, not divisible by 3. If we have 1, 1, it is divisible by 3. If we have 0, 1, 1, it is divisible by 3. Why? Because the decimal value is 3. If we have any number of zeros and 1, 1, it is divisible by 3. If we have 1, 0, not divisible by 3. If we have 0, 1, 0, not divisible by 3. If we have any number of 0, then 1, 0, then it is not divisible by 3. If we have strings like 1, double 0, not divisible, 0, 1, double 0, not divisible, 0, 0, 1, double 0, not divisible, and so on. You can have any number of zeros before this. If you have string like 1, 0, 1, not divisible by 3, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, not divisible by 3, and so on. If you have strings like 1, 1, 0, it is divisible by 3. Any number of zeros before this, 1, 1, 0, divisible by 3. If you have strings like 1, 1, 1, not divisible by 3. Any number of zeros before this, 1, 1, 1, this is not divisible by 3. If you have strings like 1, double 0, not divisible by 3. If you have string like 1, 0, 0, 0, 1,
How is it divisible by 3? Because it is representing the number which is this number which is 9. So see, you can try to solve this in this manner, and you can see if it is very difficult to identify a pattern. For example, the numbers which are divisible by 3, either they are ending with 00. Now here the number is ending with 10. Here the number is ending with 01. If you try to identify what is the pattern, then obviously it will be very difficult. It will take a lot of time for you to identify that pattern. Obviously you can do it this way. I can show you how to do it this way. But it will be very time consuming and it will be very confusing for you. I want to make simple things as simple as possible for you. So let me show you what is the simplest method of solving these kinds of questions. And here they are saying, we want to divide binary numbers, the decimal value of binary numbers by 3. So best way is, you can make a table, state transition table. And I want to know what are the remainders which we can get. For example, if you want to divide a number by 3, then you can get a remainder 0, you can get a remainder 1, as well as you can get a remainder 2. You are going to get 3 remainders. If you want to divide a number by x, then the remainders will be 0, 1, 2, up so on x minus 1. So if you are dividing a number by 3, you are going to get 3 remainders 0, 1, 2. So let us take 3 states to represent all these 3 remainders. Remainders are 0, which is represented by k0. Remainders are 1, which is represented by q1. Remainders are 2, which is represented by q2. Right? And initial state is always remainder 0. That means if you divide 0 by 3, then you will get remainder 0. Right? So q0 is the initial state. And if you want to divide a number by 3, obviously the remainder should be 0. Because if you divide a number by 3, if a number is x, and if you divide it by 3, then whatever you are going to do, you are going to get a remainder 0 if this number is perfectly divisible by 3. Right, so that is why this will be a final state. And here it is a binary number. It is a binary number. So that means we are having two symbols. The symbols are 0 and 1. Now simple shortcut trick is, write all these three in sequence here, like this is q0, q1, q2, again q0, q1, q2. Now this state transition table is representing the solution DFA. For example, if you see, we have three states. States are q0, we have q1, and we have q2, initial and final state both are q0. If you give 0 to q0, then we'll state at q0. If you give 1 to q0, then we'll state at go to q1. If you give 0 to q1, then we'll go to q2. If you give 1 to q1, then we'll go to q0. In case of q2, if you give 0, in case of q2, if you give 0, then we'll go to q1. In case of q2, if you give 1, then we'll go to q2 itself. Okay. Now this is representing the solution DFA. Let us check. If you have a string any number of 0, then they should be accepted because they are divisible by 3. So if you give any number of zeros, you will always state it q0. Now second is, if you get any number of zeros followed by 2 ones, any number of zeros, after getting the first one, we'll go from q0 to q1. After getting the second one, we'll go from q1 to q0. Right, that means it is accepted. So all these strings are accepted. If we have 1, 0, for example, initial 1, and then we have 0, then we'll be at state q2. It will not be accepted. Anything, this will not be accepted. If we have 1, double 0, for example, 1, 1, 1, 0, and 0. If we have 1, double 0, then we'll and it's state q1, so it will not be accepted. If we have 1, 1, 0, right, so after seeing the first one, we go from q1 to q1. After seeing the second one, we go from q1 to q0. After seeing the 0, we stay at q0, therefore it is accepted. If you get triple 1, so this q0 to q1, q1 to q0, q naught to q naught. So triple worth is not accepted. Assume we have 4 times of 1, 2, 3, 4. That means this number is actually representing a decimal value which is 15. Now this 4 times 1 is accepted, therefore we are going to make, after seeing the first one, we are going to make a transition from q naught to q1. After seeing the second one, we are going to make a transition from q1 to q0. After seeing the third one, we are going to make a transition from q0 to q1. After seeing the fourth one, we are going to make a transition from q1 to q0. Okay, so we are going to make these kind of transitions. So you can clearly see, if you take any binary string, then that binary string is divisible by 3.